Cleaning your vault is one of the most overrated things you can do in Destiny 2. The reality is there are so many different weapons and armor in the game that you can choose from, especially if you have more than one character, that there's just a lot of things you can make combinations out of. So to me, there's no justifiable reason to ever keep your vault at a super low number. There's always going to be more loot to chase. That said, a light cleanup of your vault every now and again can't hurt. And whether you want to completely empty your vault or just delete a couple duplicates, I'm going to show you two quick tools that can help you manage your vault. Now, today's video is a little bit more geared towards returning players and new players, but veteran players, if you want to stick around and watch the video and then yell out how many things I have in my vault, feel free to do that too, and leave a comment while you're at it. The two tools we're using today are going to be Destiny Recipes as well as Destiny Item Manager. To do all this, we're going to break it down into a three-step process. Step one, we're going to log into Destiny Recipes and get all of our items situated. Of course, I'm not going to show you all my password, but you can easily navigate to the destinyrecipes.com website, and in the upper right-hand corner, whether you're on desktop or on mobile, it's better to use on desktop, you'll be able to locate where you can log in. You can log in using your Bungie.net login information, or you can utilize your Steam or whatever platform that you're using. Now, Destiny Recipes actually has a lot to offer, which we're going to break down in future videos, but what we're going to focus on today is specifically the Vault Cleaner tool. So what you're going to do is navigate over to Vault Cleaner, click it, and then you'll now see all of the items that you have available to reorganize and look through. I will tolerate absolutely no slander as to what I have in my vault. Mind your business. But the first thing we see is the opportunity to categorize what we actually want to keep and not keep. When you log into the site, there's already options selected for you about what typically is good to keep and what's not to keep. Again, it's totally up to you what you want to select and deselect, but the options that are already set up for you are pretty much good to go. As you can see here, the only option that I really have switched around that you'll see when you log into your own site is in this corner right here under armor options, where the default is keep all armor 65 and up. For me, because of the way that I grind, I don't always grind master content or content where I get a lot of armor that is 65 plus, just because that's not a priority for me. A priority for me is having more functional builds, which again, we'll have another video on. So for me, I actually lowered that to say I'm cool with keeping things that are 63 and up. So anything that is 63 and up, it would automatically select to keep, and anything that is below 63 in terms of armor stats, it will highlight and select for things to be deleted. Once you've selected or deselected all that you want, then you can scroll down to where it says Review My Vault. When you click Review My Vault, it now shows you all of the armor and weapons that you have and what they would categorize from Destiny's recipe side as things to keep and then things to remove. As you'll see on the left-hand side where it says Progress, it will filter through every archetype of weapon and armor that you have, as well as a breakdown of the subclasses. So you don't get too overwhelmed with everything that's being thrown in your face, and you have a good opportunity to really go one by one of the different categories of what you like to keep and not keep. This is where it gets down to personal preference. For me, I feel like my auto rifle catalog is in a pretty good place, and so I'm not too concerned about things that I'm keeping and not keeping. As well as you scroll down, you can see that most of the picks that I already have are one PvE picks as someone who is a PvE main, as well as most of them are in the keep category. So Destiny Recipe is already saying that most of the roles that I have are good roles that are solid roles, as well as anything that I might want to switch over. In particular, if you're looking at this Sorrow's Verse, if I wanted to switch one of those over, it's very easily that even if Destiny Recipe says to keep it because it classifies it as good role, I can drag it over and I can put it into the red category, which is the throwaway or trash role. To help you make these decisions, you actually hover over the weapon or armor itself, and then it'll actually not only tell you the stats of that piece that you're looking at, but also when you scroll down and look at the perk options specifically, it will highlight which are the options that are good for PvE, which is highlighted with the blue shield icon, what are good for PvP, which is highlighted with the red icon, and then what are universally just good traits, again, as per the Destiny Recipes website, with the golden trophy. Once you feel like you've completed a section, you can scroll down to the bottom and then you can click next to go to the next section, in which after auto rifles, it's automatically pulse rifles. From there, it's rinse and repeat. It's a very simple process of clicking on the weapons, seeing what rolls you have available, what Destiny recipes classify as good rolls and bad rolls, and you continue from there. So again, we're looking at Destiny recipes as an opportunity to really categorize and organize the different roles that we have. So we're not quite at the point of where we're actually selecting things to be deleted or kept. This is a tool that's allowing us a little bit more clarity about what's classified as a good role or a bad role. Obviously, if you're more seasoned in the game, you can be a little bit more specific and a little bit more intricate in terms of the decisions you're making about roles in terms of your own play style or things like that. But again, as a new light or as a returning player, it's a pretty good sense of what is actually a good role or a bad role. There is a lot of opinions about roles, so take everything with a grain of salt. But if you enjoy the role, you enjoy how it feels when you're playing with it, choose to keep it. If you don't like it, you can always throw it away and try and get a better role. I will not bore you with the rest of the categories, but again, you can imagine it's just rinse and repeat, but I will highlight quickly what it looks like for the armor. So when you go to the armor option and you've gone through all the categories, this is what it will look like. For the armor, again, remember I selected that I want to keep everything that's 63 power and up, so I can categorize that for different builds around different exotics or different things that I want to pull together. And then you'll see right here where I'm looking at my helmets, I have all the ones that are above 63, and then we have ones that fall below that. And so for the purposes of this, if I just want to keep this as is, these three options right here will go into the category of trash while I'm keeping the rest of my helmets for the different various builds that I have. One thing to keep in mind when you're going through this process and you are gathering what you want to keep and what you don't want to keep, when you actually like make the decision, and we'll talk about this in the next step, to actually delete something, you do have to keep in mind that if you had a build or a loadout connected to that piece of armor, that piece of armor is no longer going to show up, obviously, because it's trash, but then that also kind of breaks any build that you had connected with it. So again, just keep that in mind that as you're deleting and fixing up your vault, that anything that's connected to something that you possibly want to get rid of, you will have to replace in any loadouts that you have. All right, so you've taken your time, you've gone through all your weapons and armor, and when you get to the last page, you've clicked through everything, you'll see something that looks similar to what's on the screen. Obviously, your vault looks different than mine, but you'll see the whole host of things that you're marking as things to delete. You'll see the things that are marked as to keep, and then also you have a total just to get a sense of what your new vault space will be. So for me, I have a lot of new freed vault space because I'd be getting rid of 56 items, which is a good amount of items, which allows me a lot of space to work from for season 19, for future builds, or if I'm just grinding different activities and I get new armor or loot. At this point, you can treat it like a checkout screen. If you're buying something online, you can't actually change anything at this point if you wanted to switch something from keep to trash, trash to keep. So this is just a review. It's kind of just reviewing everything that you're having in your cart at this point. So you can't change it. But if you do see something that at the last minute you do want to change, just go to the left-hand column, click on the category that you want to switch up, and then you can change from there. But once you get to this end screen, this is just telling you what is classified as to keep and what's classified as throwaway. All right, so we're almost at the end of this part of the process, phase one. And so now you have the option when you scroll all the way down to take it to the next step. What you can do is there is a button that goes to DIM, which is going to be the next tool that we talk about. And then you can copy the DIM query. Copying the DIM query just simply means it'll give us a kind of code that we can copy from Destiny recipes and post into DIM that's going to show us all the things that we've selected here. One of the key things to understand is currently there's no direct way to use any third-party software to delete things inside of Destiny. Destiny did say with Lightfall there's going to be different changes to the way that we can interact with our character and the armors and the builds that we have that they're going to put natively in the game. And again, we don't know what that's going to fully look like. But again, right now, until we get to Lightfall, which Lightfall is still a little bit away, this is a great way to categorize what you like to keep and not keep, and then be able to utilize these third-party softwares to organize it, and then once you get inside the game, actually do what you want to do. We're looking good, we're feeling good. We'll click copy DIM query. It'll say that it's copied, and then we're going to move over to DIM. All right, so we're in DIM. And again, you will not see my password at all. But again, you will see a prompt if you're not already logged into DIM to log in with your Bungie ID, your Steam ID, whatever platform that you're using. It's very simple and straightforward. And you'll see a screen like this where you'll see all the characters that you have created, and then you'll see your vault. And then we paste the query from Destiny Recipes into Destiny Item Manager so that everything we want to get rid of is now highlighted and everything that we want to keep is grayed out. Again, Destiny Recipes was just categorizing things and putting things into boxes. And now once we put it into Destiny Item Manager, we can now highlight and get ready to get rid of the things that we don't want. And then once you've done that, the easiest thing that you can do, in my opinion, again, there's other ways that you can do this, is to then unlock everything that you don't want to keep. Again, I'm going to repeat myself. Unlock everything that you don't want to keep. What this does, because we cannot use any third-party app, whether it's Destiny's Recipes, whether it's Destiny Inventory Manager, whether it's any other third-party site that's not from Bungie, we can't actually click and delete. There's not an option for it. There's not an ability for them to do that. So what you can do instead is we're now taking the boxes that we just got, the organized boxes that we got from Destiny Recipes. We highlighted them in DIM and we know where they're located. And now we can tease them out by unlocking them. So when we go into our actual character screen, when we log into Destiny, we know exactly where things are and we know exactly what we need to get rid of. And it's a pretty straightforward process. What this does is that when we get to Destiny and we've logged on and everything's in there and we go to the helm or to the tower to check out our vault status, now we can see firsthand what are some of the newest items that we just put into the vault. Again, the things that we want to delete, and they'll be at the very front for us to easily access. From there, you can easily click and delete, and it's out of your way. Again, every item that you delete is gone forever. So again, we've gone through the process of making sure that we're not deleting any god rolls or anything that are really high stat value. But just in case you accidentally clicked a button you didn't mean to, this is the final stop before it's gone forever. But again, we should be feeling good at this point about what we want to delete from our vault and clean up a little bit, especially if we have duplicates or blues, because Bungie is still dropping blues on us. And we just hold to delete whatever your interact keys, we hold to delete it and it's out of our way. For my new lights and returning players, as you get more comfortable in the game and you're settled in, you'll more easily be able to eyeball when you first get gear what is good gear and not gear. So for me, I just like to hoard things. That's why my vault looks like the way it is. So believe me, I know what's in my vault and I know what I have. I'm just keeping certain things for examples for this video. But as you get into the game and you've gotten something, you've just completed Master Catch Crash, for example. Yes, it may be 1580 loot, but it actually doesn't have really good stats that you want. So you can just delete it on site rather than actually sending it to your postmaster or your vault and then having everything get clogged up. But even with that, you can still send things to your vault to review later or to try out with the build later, and using your vault as an opportunity to check out what are the things that actually fit your playstyle. Again, I'm primarily play support on all three of my characters, Warlock, Hunter, and Titan. And so for me, I like to keep a lot of armor and weapon combinations that are actually more support focused than offensive focused. So it's the opportunity for you to just kind of test out what feels good for you and what doesn't. And then what you don't need, you can just delete. And if you really were like, oh, I want that thing again, just get in the game and grind for it again. But all in all, this is a pretty straightforward process. It's pretty quick and easy. Again, we're taking a little bit more time here to walk folks through it and explain it at a little bit slower pace. But honestly, when you're doing the whole thing, it takes no more than like 7 minutes, if that. If it even takes 7 minutes to log into Destiny Recipes, go through the vault cleaner option as step one, step two, copy the query into Destiny Item Manager, select what you want to delete by unlocking it, hop into Destiny, and then just delete away. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. So that's all we have for today's walkthrough. Don't let anybody shame you about the number of things that you have in your vault, but also don't let your vault get too wild and out of control. Okay. You know, don't only have like 2 spaces open, you know, at least have like 10 spaces open or 20 spaces open. But again, these two tools, Destiny Recipes and Destiny Item Managers, are great opportunities for you to check in with what's in your vault, what are duplicates, what do you actually don't need, and also kind of pushes you to really understand what can you keep and what can you grind for that's actually going to fit your playstyle, which is something we're going to go into in further videos. So stay tuned, like, comment, subscribe so you can be involved with the community here. We do put community posts on all our platforms. So again, with Twitch, with Twitter, with YouTube, find us everywhere. Why am I saying us? Find me everywhere at all of our platforms. And we'd love to continue the discussion here. And if you like this walkthrough, please hop in the comment section and let me know what other walkthroughs you'd like and what else we can talk to you from a new light, returning player, or potentially even a veteran player perspective. We'd love to hear from you. Appreciate your time. Peace.